Happy New Year and welcome to a new episode of Pure Fantasy or Not. Let's talk about the recurrent question I got regarding the existence of a multiverse or parallel universes. Mostly because of my video Star Size Comparison 2, in which I decided to show the possibility of one at the end using a question mark. While everything up to that point is backed up by science, from there on it's a highly controversial topic. Not only in YouTube comments, also among scientists. Some people even say it was pure fantasy, so is it? What many argue is that there's a lack of evidence. Does a lack of evidence always mean something is pure fantasy? Let's do a thought experiment. Somebody throws a stone and there's a wall in the way with an impossibility to see the path of the stone. We can estimate the path by using mathematics based on the known laws of physics. But you could also say we don't have evidence. Therefore, it could also have gone this way. Everything behind the wall is pure fantasy. The problem is that we constructed models that describe how our universe works. And whenever these models predict something, you cannot just opt out and say it was pure fantasy. You have to start and look for evidence. Unfortunately, in the case of the multiverse, evidence is impossible per definition sometimes, as we are bound to our universe. It is very similar to the problem with black holes. We know they are real, we know where they are, but due to all known laws of physics, it is impossible to get any information or evidence from beyond the event horizon. Our mathematics, based on what we know about how the universe works, tell us what happens inside, but there is no way to get evidence for that. So should we say black holes don't have an inside being pure fantasy? Or should we say science stops at the event horizon? In some way we already know of a place outside of our universe, and you could even send things there theoretically. One way. Now, if some models that describe how our universe works say that there must be a multiverse, we must take this seriously. So what are possible types of parallel universes? What is our universe anyway? It is all places around us where light has had time to reach us. According to Einstein, the speed of light is the speed of reality. We will never get information from places or have influence on places which you could not reach with light speed. So we are bound to the so-called observable universe around us. The inflation model tells us there is more space even further from us that travels away from us faster than the speed of light. So light from there will never reach us. It is kind of the opposite problem of the black hole. But we know that there must be more galaxies out there. You could as well say they are in another universe. So this is a so-called level 1 multiverse. There is not much controversy about that, given space beyond our observable universe is infinite. But in newer studies we even found the first evidence for space-time being curved. That means our universe might not be infinite. Currently, scientists are trying to combine the working models of quantum physics and relativity to a single unified theory. If the result has several solutions, it predicts there being a huge number of other universes with different cosmological constants and laws of nature. This is the kind of multiverse I showed in Star Size Comparison 2. It would also answer the questions why these constants of nature are the way they are. We are a result of a universe with the constants in a way that enables there being planets and stars, as well as life. If you think about it, we have made the same mistake again and again in history. We said, the Earth is the center of the universe. No, it is not, it rotates around the Sun. The solar system is the universe. No, it is just one of billions having planets in our galaxy. The galaxy is the universe. No, it is just one of billions of galaxies in the cosmic web. Okay, the cosmic web is the universe. This time, for sure. It could be that the reason why there is a special planet like Earth in 700 quintillion planets in our universe could be the same why our universe is special. This would be a level 2 multiverse. What we don't know is if universes can collide. If they did, we would see it in the cosmic background radiation. The next type of multiverse is really a parallel one. According to quantum physics, contradictory to common sense, elementary particles can be at several places at once, being only at one place when measured, jumping through impenetrable borders while moving, or being connected with others over arbitrary distances instantaneously. This is real. We can make models of their behavior. A lot of technology is based on it already for a long time. Now we even begin to build quantum computers that, by exploiting these facts, will be able to calculate things that would be impossible to calculate in reasonable amounts of time with a regular computer. There is an approach of explaining this strange behavior of particles by saying all of the possible positions of elementary particles are real. We kind of calculate in different realities at the same time. That means every outcome of history that could have happened did. There would be a universe where you have a different life or do not exist as real as ours. Every moment that happens splits in a near infinite number of other universes. This would be a level 3 multiverse. You know, after uploading Star Size Comparison 2, two things happened regarding the multiverse part. One is a film producer asked me for the clip to use in a pitch meeting for a series he wanted to produce for Netflix, dealing with alternate realities. The other one is a fellow YouTuber who contacted me producing an independent documentary series called Before the Big Bang, Skydive Phil. He managed to have interviews with the world's greatest minds on cosmology, including Stephen Hawking, about how our universe could come into being. You should check it out. I provided a few animations for the project. Also, keep in mind it is not dumbed down for the audience. A few things are really hard to grasp, but I'm happy this series exists. I'm honored to have received contact to experts in that topic. Link is in the description. So the answer to the question, does the multiverse exist, is still unknown. I would argue that the answer, pure fantasy or refusing to deal with the subject, is the wrong approach. But let me know your thoughts. In the end, there's also the idea of a level 4 multiverse, dealing with the fact that something exists at all. It combines all previous types and says abstract mathematics itself is real, and all that it can express is a reality in some way. This is of course the most controversial one, and I understand why. But in some way I had a similar thought on my own before getting more into the subject. At the end of Star Size Comparison 2 I wrote, "What if nothing never existed? What if there is and always was, and everything forever?" I'm on 1415 and the real world is incredible.